Michael, Margie, where are we now? We are on the steps of the cathedral in Evreux. We stopped in Evreux and Lisieux. We're on our way to the Normandy invasion beaches. We stopped in all the cities, the cathedral cities, on the way there. Of course, we've been to Rouen many times, but now we're in Evreux. As a beautiful cathedral. It's about a 6-hour, Normandy was about a 6-hour drive from Paris. Evreux was about halfway, so we're maybe 3.5 hours out of Paris now. We're probably only 2.5 because we had the Autobahn up to Evreux almost, and then it's back roads, or used to be back roads, from Evreux through Lisieux, through Caen. We're going to stop in Caen also. Karen and Margie, looking through the back window of the Volvo. Just a small pack on this trip. This is just a weekend. Everything was in bloom. I think it was May. Trees look like they've got all their buds popping. Films are beginning to fade, I think. It's not a true color. Yes, Evreux. If you look on the map of France, you'll see that there's almost a direct line off the Autobahn through Evreux and Lisieux. Some beautiful cathedrals here. Jeanne d'Arc days from Joan of Arc. The religious wars. France, of course, is a very Catholic country. Probably rivals Italy as the country with the most highest percentage of population that are of the Catholic faith. And this might be Lisieux now. I think we are in Lisieux. Didn't mention before, there's other kids in the back of the wagon. Back's back, everybody. This is where the meaning back's back. Keep your back into the back of your seat. Don't lean forward. Buckle up. Some of the dukes of France and their signs. Here's a moat. Oh, this might be Caen now. Yeah, this is Caen. This is the old walled fortress, city fortress. Goes around the old central part of Caen, some of the cathedrals. These are the ramparts from which William the Conqueror fought in 1071. So this is a 900-year-old plus relic, still in excellent condition. There's the moat defending the castle and the city, looking down the wall to give you a feeling of how high this fortress is. There's one of the warriors who protected the city, Queen of Caen. Caen is spelled C-A-E-N. There's another view of the walled fortress. Adri coming up the steps, looking cold, a little bit windy up there, huh? Michael, make sure you protect your queen. Karen, Tommy, Mike, Margie, and there's the Cathedral of Caen. Had some splendid Romanesque abbey churches in Caen. I think that's the Church of La Trinité. And we'll get another view. Look at those beautiful flying buttresses there. Gorgeous design, right in the heart of downtown. When World War II, when the invasion occurred, they just about destroyed the old city of Caen, which in a way took away the cluster and clutter of homes that were surrounding all these edifices. So when they rebuilt, they left a lot of light around the churches. Now there's GBF with his gang. Karen, I guess that's Margie and Mike, and must be Tommy. Two Toms taking movies already. What a kid. Tommy, you're doing a good job. Yeah. Is that Adri there? No. Hair's too long. Yeah, Margie. Margie's flying around the castle. What a little monkey girl. Bye-bye, Tommy. And here's the cannons protecting William the Conqueror. No, this is after, before his time. The Saint Etienne, Saint Etienne Church is where William the Conqueror is buried. So Caen was one of the famous cities, one of the most important cities in Europe at the time. Backlighting was not too good here. Another view of the fortress. Camera was getting a little shaky. I was having motor problems already in 74. Seems that's the what goes with these cameras is the motors. The motor drives the film or the tape. Gives up before anything else. See if I can speed this up a little bit. Bulkheads and bridgehead is the word, high-tech bridgehead that was dropped in the bay, towed all the way from England, and you can still see in the distance the remains here 40 years later after the war, or 30 years at that time, but it's still there now 50 years later. Those bridgeheads are still in place, taking a pounding. There's some sections of it. They dropped pieces to block the waves, and then they built a bridgehead out into the bay. There was no natural, or this was a natural bay, but there was no port here, is what I'm trying to say. Hello, Adri. And they made a man-made bay port within a day and began the unloading of tanks and all the heavy weapons, and of course the men were coming in on their landing barges. And this is the beaches of the Normandy invasion. I did a term paper in high school, Crosby, in 1953 about the 1944 invasion in 1944. So 9 years after this, I did a term paper, and then 30 years later, I come back and visit it. Very traumatic experience for anybody who lived through those war years. That's the name of the beach, is Aramanche, and what they called the port was Port Winston. And it was the key of the liberation of Europe. This invasion, if it had failed, would have delayed the war by another 2 or 3 years till they found another place to invade Europe. Maybe through Norway or Sweden, because Germany had, you'll see later, some of these, the bunkers that are all over the place. There's more pieces of the bridgehead, and you can see the waves hitting and sending up that stream of water over these pieces of the walkway and bridgeheads that were there, bulkheads. The museums that they have there have some very beautiful films, interesting films of the invasions that were shot as the invasion was taking place. So we're soaking up the history here. We're going to the American Military Cemetery, and Pont du Hoc was one of the signposts, one of the key places the raiders, paratroopers, came to Pont du Hoc. That was their rendezvous point. And there's Giscard d'Estaing, who was running for the Premier of France. He won that year and then was defeated before we left France by Mitterrand, current Premier. He's been Premier for 15 years or so. The Aramanche Museum was just set in a typical coastal village in this artificial port of the Mulberry Beachhead invasion. Can be seen from all the hills around, and the films and mementos in the museums are interesting. Very sad sight to see these thousands upon thousands perfectly laid out crosses. This is the American Military Cemetery at Saint Laurent, overlooking the Omaha Beach. That statue is dedicated to the American youth and their desire for freedom, flight, erected by the Americans, of course. I don't think the French spend a penny for maintaining any of the American sites in France. It's all American expense, comes out of the military budget. That's a very beautiful statue depicting American youth's desire for freedom. Very expressive. Almost has a bisexual, very muscular, but still gives a bisexual connotation. Of course, there were no women fighting in uniform at that time. This is the scene, that Omaha Beach scene was the greatest amphibious troop landing in history. where the 1st, 4th, and 29th American Division